qué lindo eres.
You know, ancient insects were not the only things trapped in amber back when dinosaurs roamed the earth. In fact, just this year alone, we found bird wings, dinosaur feathers, and now this, a nearly intact baby bird from around 100 million years ago. In fact, it's the most complete prehistoric bird we have ever found. Scientists found the amber in Myanmar, and inside you can see the bird's head, its tail, its neck, and especially the wings and the claw feet. And it's really incredible because the tree sap seemed to have preserved everything perfectly. According to Ryan McKellar from the Royal Saskatchewan Museum in Canada, it's the most complete and detailed view we've ever had. Seeing something this complete is amazing, it's just stunning. This bird belonged to a group known as Enantiornithes, or opposite birds, which went extinct about 65 million years ago at the end of the Cretaceous period along with the dinosaurs. These birds appear to look like the birds of today, but according to New Scientist, they had a socket and ball joint in their shoulders, where modern birds have a ball and socket joint, hence the name observers. They also had claws on their wings and jaws and teeth rather than beaks. It is still a mystery why these birds died off while other ancestors of modern birds did not. And here researchers think this might have something to do with the fact that these birds were really lousy parents and often just left their babies alone to fend for themselves. Also, researchers believe that these birds were actually hatched on the ground and then climbed up into the tree, which might explain why these birds were so easily stuck in tree sap. The amber was mined in the Hukong Valley in northern Myanmar. Ambers found in this region contain some of the largest variety of life from the Cretaceous period, which was from 145 to 65 million years ago. And if you're already thinking a Jurassic Park scenario in your head, you're probably not alone. Unfortunately, there really is not much DNA left, as the flesh itself has already turned into unusable carbon. And you know, this whole Jurassic Park scenario might not be too far-fetched, because nowadays researchers are actually thinking about, or attempting even as we speak, to bring certain extinct creatures back to life. So while it could be really exciting to see a real live woolly mammoth, I'm kind of terrified of this whole cloning thing, because you know it's just a matter of time before we start cloning humans. And then maybe it becomes more widespread. Maybe there will be companies that is willing to bring back a loved one that you've lost. And next thing we know, there will be millions of soulless human clones ruling the earth. Okay, I don't know how I went from a 100 million year old baby bird amber to the clone apocalypse, but yeah, I just went there. Anyway, guys, like I mentioned, I thought this was really cool, so wanted to share it with you guys. All right, have a great weekend. Happy Friday. I'll see you later.